officer who arrested him, Gerald Goins, was the only witness. Now that officer is himself charged with murder and lying in a different case. Goins pleaded not guilty and is awaiting trial. All of the defendants are minorities, and the overwhelming majority are African Americans.
Wrong.
Folks, I have to apologize. My channel has apparently become solely focused on race, a topic I'm not too inclined to talk about. Not because I'm scared or I have any guilt, like I said before, but because we can't have an honest conversation, and if that's the case, I'm not interested. Telling the truth and putting forth hard data is simply met with charges of racism and white supremacy. No thanks.
I'm Amy Horowitz, and the protests that have convulsed our nation are based on the premise that the police are racist writ large, that they target black people for death. But the statistics don't support that conclusion. The data doesn't support that there's racial police brutality. More black people, more unarmed.
All the way off. All the way off.
So you don't care about the data?
All the way off. Your data can go suck the same you're gonna go suck.
So no, I'd much rather be talking about election politics or the upcoming debates that are sure to be hilarious. We'll get right back into this episode, but first, let me quickly tell you about this free special offer for my subscribers. What will your savings and retirement look like once we've declared victory over the virus? Many Americans use this little-known IRS-qualified loophole that allows Americans to buy gold and silver with their retirement accounts. Call today and request a free investment kit below. Mention Dronetek Politics and get a free 1 ounce silver coin for qualified retirement account holders. Must be over 40 to qualify. Call 866-915-5053 and get your free investment guide today. However, the main reason we can't talk about this topic is because the media purposely presents a very lopsided picture for the purposes of advancing a Democrat Party agenda. They purposely bury crime stats and victim surveys because it literally debunks their claims of systemic racism. They only ever make an issue of white cops or white people victimizing black people, never the other way around. And it's way more prevalent to have black on white violence and murder than it is the other way. Beyond that, they just outright misrepresent the data. For example, they always dismiss the black-on-black violence argument by claiming that every group has violence within their own race. The problem is, black-on-black violence is way higher than any other group. Yeah, I know these stats are from 2008, but it doesn't matter. They remain consistent up to our present year. And when you're talking about Black Lives Mattering and you're pointing the finger at white people, it doesn't really make sense when the vast majority of black murder comes from black people. And not just that, but it happens at rates far higher than any other group. That's the issue. In those rare cases when the media covers a police brutality story about a white victim, race is never the central premise of the story. In fact, when there's white victims, the media will just report on them generally as people. Even when the officers are black and the victims are white, the media will never make a racial issue of those kind of stories. Another example, when black officers launched a no-knock raid on an innocent white couple that ended in their deaths. The media might report on it, but race is never a factor that's ever even mentioned.
Two other news, and two former Houston police officers are under arrest tonight for an alleged drug raid that left two people dead and five officers injured. Search warrants claim the occupants of a home were selling heroin. The two people who lived there were killed in the raid. There was no heroin found.
Today in federal court, two former Houston police officers, who were once hailed as heroes, faced a judge indicted on charges stemming from a police raid that left two people dead and four officers shot.
Fast forward a year, and now those two black cops have been arrested and charged for the murder of those two innocent white people. Given no-knock raids are a big story right now, NBC actually covered it. The same network that edited 911 audio and turned a clearly Latino man into a white Hispanic has now claimed two white victims of a botched no-knock raid were people of color.
Floyd pleaded guilty to selling less than a gram of cocaine. As part of a deal, he served 10 months in jail. The officer who arrested him, Gerald Goins, was the only witness. Now that officer is himself charged with murder and lying in a different case. Goins pleaded not guilty and is awaiting trial. All of the defendants are minorities, and the overwhelming majority are African Americans.
That's right, a black cop that murdered two innocent white people, but that NBC is covering as, quote, all minorities or African Americans. So what we apparently have here is two corrupt black cops that lied to get this no-knock warrant against these two innocent people. That does not fit the narrative. So they just lied. This incident does reflect what I and many others have been saying for a long time now. that while police brutality and just general bad training are an issue, it's not a racial issue. There's no evidence that any of this has anything to do with the conspiracy theory known as systemic racism. In order to keep that narrative going, the media literally just lies and ignores all stories not fitting the mold. No doubt this will just be chalked up as another one of their mistakes that only ever cut in one direction. It might almost be believable if NBC didn't have a long track record of blatantly lying to stir up racial tensions. I already mentioned that they edited the 911 tape to make Zimmerman's call seem racist, and they also claim that he was white when he's clearly Latino. And another similar incident that I've mentioned many times, MSNBC actually cropped video of a black man at a Tea Party rally so that they could hyperbolically claim it was a bunch of racist whites who hated a black man in the White House.
Yesterday, as President Obama addressed the veterans of foreign wars in Phoenix, a man at a pro-healthcare reform rally just outside wore a semi-automatic assault rifle on his shoulder and a pistol on his hip. Also, there are questions about whether this has racial overtones. I mean, here you have a man of color in the presidency and white people showing up with guns strapped right to their waists legs.
It sounds simplistic when you put it that way, but it is real that there is tremendous anger in this country about government and the way government seems to be taking over the country, anger about a black person being president.
So later in the day on the MSNBC show The Beat, the host also brought up this case after a report on Kentucky's decision to clamp down on no-knock raids. And unbelievably, once again, the MSNBC host claimed that the victims of this officer were people of color. How can all of these supposedly professional journalists be making all of these mistakes? This is easily researchable, and as I showed you earlier, NBC already reported on this story once in 2019.
In fact, Houston prohibited no-knock warrants after two civilians were killed in a fatal drug raid there. Now, Houston is expecting to overturn more than 100 cases tied to that officer. All, listen to what I'm about to say, all of those defendants are people of color. Harris County District Attorney saying it is, quote, not just a coincidence, but a product of a systemic problem in the way drug enforcement occurs.
Wrong.
So if you get on YouTube and you look up this Houston police chief, who's not white, by the way, you're gonna find lots of interviews with him about George Floyd, but not a single question about this case involving two white victims. Even though no-knock raids are a big topic right now, the media simply can't report on these stories if they involve white people, because if they did that, people would get a greater context and see that it's not black people being specifically targeted. No, they'll just keep burying those stories so they can continue stirring the racial pot and perpetuating this myth that this country is systemically racist. That's all for this episode. As always, folks, if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. It really helps this channel. If you'd like to support this channel, you can do so on one of these platforms. You can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.